In the recent months and years, there has been an increase in the occurrence of natural disasters around the world. These happenings have been attributed to increased human activities and their effects on climate change. However, some have posited the possibility of another more mysterious force at play, God's judgment. The human population has grown by leaps and bounds in the last millennia, owing largely to advances in technology. It has been said that the growth of cities, the discovery of oil and innovations in mechanized farming, mining, and transportation have led to increased greenhouse gas emissions and the depletion of the ozone layer. But is this enough to justify the mysterious increase in natural disasters all over the world? On the other side of this argument are those that attribute all life's events to a spiritual source, a higher consciousness. Their justification comes from prophecies that have their origins thousands of years ago, some of which have already come to pass and others still playing out in the present. The proponents of this belief system refer to ancient scripture texts of the Abrahamic faith. They believe that God, through the prophets, told of an end of days that would be preceded by signs and wonders. Luke 21:10-11 KJV. Then said he unto them, Nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. Weathered and great earthquakes shall be in diverse places, and famines and pestilences, and fearful sights and great signs shall there be from heaven. Where science has been reactive, only offering plausible cause after the effect, men of God have been forecasting events before they happen, demonstrating that their God has the upper hand in this argument. The demonstration of God's hand in the affairs of men isn't something new in the very least. Since men first walked the earth, their lives and livelihoods have centered around the belief in a higher power, a mystical God whose laws transcend human wisdom and limitations. The belief in higher spiritual entities has been a central theme in the life of all peoples until this day. So is the proliferation of natural disasters being witnessed today a result of natural human forces, or is it a consequence of the disobedience of men as prophesied in Scripture? There is a rise of a new breed of prophet who speaks the very oracles of God, a prophet to the nations, and those who believe would do well to heed his words. For Duri, blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen as his own inheritance. The Lord looks from heaven. He sees all the sons of men. From the place of his dwelling, he looks on all the inhabitants of the earth. He fashions their hearts individually. He considers all their works. Psalm 33:12-17.
This is the testimony of Jesus. 6th December, 2022.
The time has come where the places that men looked up to as their expectation, their glory, it says it's going to be exposed, embarrassingly exposed, so much so that they will have to now turn to the Lord our God. Hallelujah. Can you imagine? Now I'm prophesying. Eh? Do you see Dubai there? Wait and see the news that is going to come from there. Eh? And you see, eh? It's going to appear like, you mean all this has been fake? And I'm telling you, and that will be a sign for you, to you, to realize that in your midst, the Lord your God has positioned himself just for you to rise up and rely on what is more real than the things that are called, that the scripture calls the glory of Egypt. I'm telling you. And there are so many things that are going to start to shake. So many things.
1 year and 4 months later, reports of unprecedented floods in the desert kingdom of Dubai top global media, shocking the world in an astounding fulfillment to the prophecy.
I have to say that this is unprecedented and uncharted territory for us.
I think it's an unprecedented event because, as we have been talking about, you know, this is a record rainfall that the country has received in 75 years. And clearly what this has demonstrated is that even though Dubai is considered one of the most advanced modern cities in terms of infrastructure and services, they clearly have fallen short when it comes to handling a situation like this where there has been unprecedented rainfall. Now, this was not anticipated. No one saw this coming.
And it's been a very challenging situation, as you correctly say. Records began here from a meteorological perspective in 1949, and we've never seen anything like this. 254 millimeters of rain falling in just 2 days. It's been unprecedented.
True to the prophetic word, the unprecedented flooding in the desert kingdom of Dubai was attributed to cloud seeding, a famed engineered marvel that results in fake rain used to fight against Dubai's desert conditions.
So much rain in such a dry country has led to speculation that it was caused by cloud seeding. The United Arab Emirates regularly sends planes into clouds to scatter tiny particles in the hope that they will draw together moisture and form raindrops.
Prophet Elvis Mbonye has continually astounded us with his record of prophecies that headline the news, change nations, and shape the very world we live in. And we accord double honor to God's foremost prophet to the nations, Prophet Elvis Mbonye.